In a previous video, we attempted to solve the equation sine theta minus cosine theta equals 1, and we wanted to find all solutions from 0 to 2 pi, and we were successful in doing that. The basic idea is we move cosine to the side, and we squared both sides. We got sine squared equals 1 plus cosine quantity squared. You FOIL that out, and then we use a Pythagorean identity to turn it into a quadratic equation. We solve it. I want to revisit this problem here because when we saw it in the previous lecture, we weren't considering any changes to the period. If you allow for period changes with your trigonometric functions, it turns out there's other ways you could solve these various problems, and then maybe you like it better. So let's see a different approach to this one. This time, I'm not going to separate the trigonometric functions because after all, unless you were trained to do so, you might not think of doing such a thing. So let's just leave it as it is and just square both sides. Now notice by squaring both sides, we are potentially entering into the equation party crashers, solutions which are not really solutions, they're fakers. So we have to make sure we check for those at the end of this problem. On the left-hand side, if we FOIL, we end up with sine squared theta minus 2 sine theta cosine theta, and then we get a plus cosine squared theta, like so. On the right-hand side, we get 1. Now, we're still going to use a Pythagorean identity. We end up with, of course, here, a sine squared plus cosine squared. That's going to give us, of course, 1. We just end up with a 1 minus 2 sine theta cosine theta. This equals 1. We can subtract 1 from both sides. We end up with negative 2 sine theta cosine theta is equal to 0. Now, at this moment, you could be like, okay, sine equals 0, of course, at 0 and pi, cosine equals 0 at pi halves and 3 pi, and then you could proceed to eliminate who's a party crasher from there. We'll come back to that in a second. This is the main, and that would be a perfectly valid approach, something that would be very appropriate for the previous lecture. What I want to do instead, though, is look at this. Well, we have a 2 sine theta cosine theta. That's just negative sine of 2 theta equals 0. Times both sides by negative 1, you get sine of 2 theta equals 0, for which then we get that 2 theta is going to equal, well, when is sine equal to 0? Sine equals 0 at 0, so you take any 2 pi multiple of that, or sine is 0 at pi, so you're going to get pi plus 2 pi k as well. So really, if you have even multiples, if you have 0 plus 2 pi k and then pi plus 2 pi k, those are just all multiples of pi. So you could just simplify that just as pi k, right, like so. And then theta, if you divide by 2 here, 2 theta divided by 2, of course, is theta. Pi k divided by 2 is you're going to get pi halves k. And notice then you reproduce all of these answers here again. So you're going to get, if you take k to be 0, you get 0. If you take k to be 1, you're going to get pi halves. If you take k to be 2, you get pi. If you take k to be 3, you get 3 pi halves. And then at 4, you've wrapped around. So you get all the same solutions. And these are what we saw previously when we tried this video another time. Now, of course, you do have to check these solutions, of course. If you plug in 0, you're going to get 0, excuse me, you're going to get 0 minus 1, which is negative 1. That doesn't work. So 0 we take away. If you try pi, you're going to get for sine, you'll get 0, you'll get a negative 1. So negative, negative 1 is positive 1. That one works out. If you try pi halves, sine is 1, cosine 0, so that one works out. And if you try 3 pi halves, you'll end up with, for sine, of course, you're going to get negative 1. For cosine, you get 0, so that doesn't work out here. So the actual solutions are pi and pi halves. This agrees with what we saw earlier, but I just want to show you different ways we could solve this same equation. The Pythagorean equation basically was unavoidable here, but we can solve it using multiple angles. And as long as you are good about your period here, remembering the 2 pi, you can get all the solutions. And this provides perhaps a simpler approach to the approach we tried earlier. So this brings us to the end of lecture 23. It also brings us to the end of our 7th unit about trigonometric equations in our lecture series. We'll see more trigonometric equations later on and other trigonometric problems. These type of things show up in calculus all the time, so it's very important that students have this skill set developed here from chapter 7. If you learned anything while watching these videos for chapter 7, please hit the like button. Subscribe if you want to see more videos about trigonometry or other mathematical topics in the future. And as always, if you have any questions, feel free to post them in the comments below, and I'll be happy to answer them at my soonest convenience. Bye, everyone.